Our next guest is serving the drama on divorce court while she is also a champion for domestic abuse prevention. She never shies away from getting these couples together. Let's take a look.
He was flirting with a woman that I didn't know about, sitting here texting back and forth.
You fuss at him on the way to the job. Mm-hmm. You never give up a dollar because you're upset. You fuss at him all the way there. You drop him off. You let him work. You pick him up. You fuss at him on the way home. But you never stand in between him and some money.
How about that? Please welcome Judge Lynn Toler.
Yes.
How are you?
It is so amazing to have you here, Judge.
Always exciting to be here.
And love you look the show. Amazing.
Thank you so much. You guys always have it together. I was talking to her earlier about your stylist because I'm going to try to steal some ideas.
Well, that's all right. That's all right. We'll lend her to you. No worries about that. But you looked absolutely amazing, drop dead gorgeous at the opening of Tyler Perry Studios. Mm-hmm. My God.
That was one of the most fantastic things I've ever done in my life. I mean, he had one surprise after another, and we were all just looking up with our mouths open. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then you run into somebody, it's Jay-Z, excuse me. You know, it's a little okay. It was wonderful.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
And it
was a homecoming. It used to be an army barracks for the Confederates.
Yes. Wow.
And now one, not a consortium, right. Not a corporation, one black man.
That's right.
He got his own 330 acres in a mule.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Absolutely.
But divorce court, it's in its 21st season. And the theme this season is we're serving up the drama. Tell us what does that mean? Because your show is already not short of drama.
Always full of drama. But we're just, this season, we're just going to let it hang. Sometimes we just kind of contained it a little bit. Oh, we think this is too much. We're going to get who we get. You know what I mean? And we're just going to let people see all of it.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna let it ride.
Now, Judge Toler, you were a judge at the Cleveland Heights Municipal Court.
Correct.
My God, some of the strangest things you've seen. What has been like something that has been so surprising? You're like, I can't believe this is happening before my eyes. And this was before the camera, before television.
I had one lady who came in on a domestic violence case. Her husband had just poked her with his cane.
Oh my.
And she was calm, I was calm, I was relaxed. She said, I was just doing it to let him know what's up. That was on a Monday. On Wednesday, I was arraigning him for shooting her in the face.
What? Golly jeepers.
Yep. Now, she happened to be jumping out the window at the time, so the bullet went through her jaw and out the other side, so she did not die. But it just goes to show you can't be casual about any
you
of
sure
it.
Yeah.
You
sure can.
You sure can. It's a real
just
thing.
Can't.
It's a real
do
thing.
Do it.
So when you saw something like that, did you feel like, you know, maybe I was too light, but how they presented it to you was very light.
It was, and it was just an arraignment, so I was just,
and
she was very relaxed, very calm. She was much younger than him. She was very in control of herself. I think that he had had a stroke not too long ago, and I think a lot of his personality changed, so she wasn't aware of how that was going to go, because everybody was shocked.
Wow. He went to jail for that.
Oh dear. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed.
Mm-hmm. He needs to be under the jail.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed.
Let's talk about your book for a moment. You have such a super busy schedule.
Yes.
And you have, I don't understand how to thin air, made the time to create your third book.
Yes.
Dear Sonali.
Yeah.
Letters to the Daughter I Never Had.
Right.
Tell me how that came about.
I married a man with four sons. I had two more boys with him from scratch. And then they never want to talk about anything.
No,
they don't
want
to tell me about how they feel.
No.
They don't want to talk about their relationships.
No.
They don't want me to tell them anything about anything. They won't even tell me their girlfriend's names.
What?
You know, I mean, I got to guess.
What?
Oh, won't bring them by. Oh, it's terrible.
Why?
But I want to have an opportunity to have all those conversations that my mother had with me.
Yeah.
And a lot of women online, especially young women, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, say, you're the auntie in my head,
yes.
Or mom number two.
Yes.
So I had a lot to share. They wanted it a lot. So I thought, I'll write it in the form of letters so you can have different topics on different days.
So I assume Sonali would have been your daughter's name.
It would have been. My best girlfriend from Cleveland was Sonali.
Mm.
I joined a law firm that was created in 1843.
Mm.
I was the first black woman they ever had in
1984,
and she was the second, and we became very, very close.
Yes.
Her name was Sonali.
Yes, yes. Why do you feel that it's important to give young women advice?
I think it's important because we're always talking about education, we're talking about money, we're mm-hmm. talking about men, but you have to talk about your inner self, your yes. personal life, who you are, mm-hmm. what glitches do you have?
Yeah.
Let's examine them, let's talk about them, because your emotional life drives the rest of your life.
So Judge Toler, you know, I always keep it real with you, and honestly, I was going through the book, and you have a quote in there. You mm-hmm. say, don't do wifely duties, and I'm paraphrasing a mm-hmm. little, don't do wifely duties while dating as a girlfriend. Why do you say that? Because I need clarity on that.
Yeah,
I
don't
really do
wife duties at girlfriend prices.
Yes.
I see a lot of young women come into my courtroom, and the dudes actually say this, you got to show me your wife material, so you got to move in, have sex with me, cook, clean, all of these kind of things, and then what happens is they get so invested in that relationship mm. in the state that it's in, they have no leverage whether to leave or not. So he mm. never marries her, and she's there stuck wanting a ring, but she has nothing, you know. Ooh. You know, my husband got his first meal after we were married.
Mm-hmm.
If I'd have cooked for him before we were married, he might not have married me, but that's a whole other story, because
right.
a sister cannot cook. But I did nothing of wife nature until after I
wow.
was one, because he had to earn that.
That's right.
Mommy said, why buy the cow? You can get the milk for free.
That's
but guess
true.
What? We will have more with the Honorable Judge Lynn Toler when we come right back. Judge Toler, in honor of our Sisters of the Court Week, we are going to play a game called Ooh. Under Oath.
All right.
Where we pick questions from this fishbowl.
Okay.
And you have to answer them as truthfully as possible.
I'm
now,
on oath.
Do you swear?
I do.
To tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
So help me
so
God.
So help the sister circle.
There you go. So
All
help
right.
the sister circle.
I like that. Juan is going to pick the first question.
I am ready. Okay. All right.
Uh-oh.
This one says, have you ever pretended your phone died?
No, because nobody calls me. I don't have to, nobody calls.
Yeah, okay.
I'm going to start calling.
Okay, you go ahead.
We're going to see if you pretend your phone
I'm call.
Dies on me. Give me some more advice.
Okay.
Have you ever lied about your height or weight? You're under oath at the
At the BMV, I lie every time about how much I weigh. The state does not know my correct weight and never will.
Now, see, I would think that you would lie about your height before your weight.
My height is just so obvious.
Yeah, it's obvious.
You know what I mean? When you 5'1", what you gonna lie about? You know? What you gonna lie about? You know?
I got another one for you, Judge. Have you ever pretended to be someone else when a bill collector has called?
No.
Mm-mm. You just pay the bills on time.
Sister pays her bills.
On time.
That's and
right.
if I, you know, I don't buy nothing I know I can't afford.
We're in the same book on that one. Hey, hold that real quick.
I will.
Miss Quad, oh my God,
baby.
With a nice bod. Okay, have you ever used a fake ID?
No.
Oh, I was the most boring juvenile. I was shy. I didn't go out. And by the time that I was going out, I went to college at 17. Everything brought on campus.
Yeah.
You know, so you didn't have to have ID. You just had to get up in the dorm room. And then I misbehaved.
All right.
As much as possible.
All right, we got one more for you.
All right. Have you ever done some things in a dorm room that you say you didn't? Real question, seriously. Have you ever stolen anything small, like a piece of candy? Anything small?
I will take somebody's pen in a minute.
An ink pen.
If you don't watch your ink pens, I'm walking out with it. Because I never have enough ink pens.
I will
take your ink pen.
All right, everybody, you heard it here first. Hide your ink pens. Jocelyn, thank you so much for coming here today.
Thank you for having me. I love the show. I love you guys, and I was excited to come.
Absolutely. And by the way, do not forget to pick up her book, Anywhere Fine Books Are Sold, Dear Sonali, The Daughter I Never Had, and the conversations continue on all social media platforms at Sister Circle TV.